It is important to be able to relate force to potential energy. Now, the book largely goes through this argument based on work, that the book originally derived where potential energy came from work. I've skipped that conversation. I think that it is a little more straightforward to actually think about potential energy directly from forces. But if you understand the book's approach, that's fine as well. So, in a way, potential energy is the integral of force because potential energy relates to work, and work was the integral of force. So, because of that, force is going to be the derivative of work, of potential. Now, we have to be a little bit careful about our notation. And one thing to recognize here is that this is for one direction. So, this would only be x or only be y, or in this case, the generalized direction of S. And in more advanced physics, we would actually get into multivariable calculus and doing partial derivatives, but we don't do that in this class. So to understand the force in a specific direction, so for instance, the force in the x direction, you would look at how potential energy is changing based on that direction. So you take the derivative, and there is a minus sign. And this is where we have to be very careful to remember that you have a positive direction and a negative direction. So the other thing to remember is that this has to be related. So we can't talk about the spring force coming from gravitational potential energy. We would talk about the gravitational force coming from gravitational potential energy. So what the sign would tell you, and this is kind of part of a parabola, so this might relate to, say, the spring force, is that if the potential is getting larger as we go to the right, that means the force is pulling it to the left, right? So we would say here that it's a positive slope, right? It's curving upwards, but the force is actually to the left. So one way to kind of check this with yourself is that potential energy for gravitational potential energy increases as you go up. However, the force pulls down. So that's why there's this minus sign here, and that can be a little bit tricky. So you're going to see a lot of plots of potential energy versus position. In this case, it's just literally a plot of that, but these potential energy curves are also going to show up on energy diagrams. So hopefully you've watched the videos about energy diagrams. And so part of why we're talking about relating forces to potential energy is because this means you can understand what's happening with your forces based on a potential on an energy diagram. So if we look at this piecewise potential energy curve, we see that we have a constant negative slope, a constant zero slope, and then a constant positive slope. So we take the derivative and we use a minus sign. So in this case, we're going to say that the force in the x direction is equal to the derivative of our potential with respect to x. And again, there's a minus sign. So initially, we have a negative slope. It's going down. That means it's a positive force. So the force by positive means to the right. So again, our positive direction is typically to the right. So in this region from 0 to 2, the force is pushing it or pulling it to the right. In this region where we have zero slope, potential energy is constant. That means there's zero force. And finally, here we have positive slope. That means that the force is pulling it to the left, that the force is negative. So be careful when you're doing all of this about the coordinate system that you're using and the sign convention. One example for this is looking specifically at springs. We know that their potential is given by a parabola and that the force is just given by a line. Now, note that the force is a negative sloped line for that. And the reason for this is that as you go to the right, the force of your spring is pulling it to the left. As you go to the left, remember this is always from equilibrium, the force is to the right. And so you see the same thing here, and you can see that it's always going to roll back to equilibrium position in the middle. So there is this relationship here that if you were to take the negative derivative of this curve, you would get this line. Obviously, if you were to integrate this line, you would get this curve. So remember that we now actually can use calculus, so derivatives and integrals with respect to position, to go between potential and force.